imagine a world filled completely with Halloween characters like ghosts and vampires, and a skeleton was the leader of all of these people. This is the world from The Nightmare Before Christmas, which was just one of the dark and unique worlds created from the mind of Tim Burton. I have watched many of the great works that have come from Tim Burton, like Nightmare Before Christmas, Corpse Bride, Edward Scissorhands, and many more. Since then, I've done research on him from biography.com, tribute.com, and a Tim Burton Collective website. Today I'm going to tell you about the life and works of Tim Burton from his early life to the beginning of his career and then to some of the movies that he has produced during his career. He is known for his unusual style and intriguing storylines and has easily become one of the most admired and famous directors today through his experience, talent, and creativity. Tim Burton's early life gave him the experience that he got to begin his directing career. He was born on August 25th, 1958. He grew up in Burbank, California, in a suburb, which he didn't really fit into. His mom always wanted him to go outside and play with kids his age, but he was more interested in horror films and art, like drawing. After graduating high school, Burton attended the California Institute of Arts, where he landed a job with Disney as an animator. His first project at Disney was actually working on Fox and the Hound. Burton was totally bored by being an animator, and Disney, I guess, saw this, and so they moved him up to being a conceptual artist. Disney allowed him to work on his own creations while he was working with them. His career really began with a story about a boy and his dog. This movie was called Frank and Weenie, which is now being reproduced as a short stop-motion animation. But this one was a much shorter version of that and was what really set off his career. Frank and Weenie is based on Frankenstein and is about a boy and his dog and the relationship that they have. And when the dog dies, the boy tries to bring him back to life. Frank and Weenie only aired overseas and was limited available on videotapes and around here. Stephen King saw this movie and recommended it, which it eventually landed in the hands of Paul Rubens, which was the creator of Pee Wee Herman. And he then recruited Tim Burton to help him produce his movie, which was Pee Wee's Big Adventure. 3 years after the production of Pee Wee's Big Adventure, Burton actually began directing his own movies and producing his own movies. During his career, Tim Burton produced many award-winning movies. He didn't really produce another film until he saw the screenplay for Beetlejuice, which was the first movie that he saw that really connected with his style and the way that he wanted to do things and his unique style. The next movie he produced was Batman, which was an award-winning hit and is still considered one of the most influential movies from Hollywood still to this day. His next movie was Edward Scissorhands, which is kind of, it relates a lot to him because it kind of shows the a man that doesn't really fit in very much living in a suburb, which goes back to his childhood. The next movie was Batman Returns, which is a sequel of Batman. One of the most famous ones that probably most of you have seen is The Nightmare Before Christmas. No. it's a stop-motion animation, which is where they make puppets, kind of, or play figures, and they'll position them the way they want them, take a picture, move them, take another picture, and so forth, and then they'll put them all together and eventually make a moving character. These are just the very few of the movies that came from the brilliant mind of Tim Burton. Some others include Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Sweeney Todd, and Alice in Wonderland. Through events in his early life, Burton worked his way up to being discovered and becoming a producer of many great and influential movies that portray his dark and unique style. Burton's creativity and talent and uniqueness got him to where he is today. Tim Burton has easily made a name for himself as a memorable, creative, and talented director. And all of his movies show his dark style and yet still have a quirkiness about them that makes